There's God's responsibility with your money and your responsibility. Let me say that again. There's God's responsibility because you're a child of God, and there's your responsibility and the law of action. This is Wayne Sutton, the second Adam.com. And today, Marketplace Monday, I want to pray over you. I want to pray for your finances. I want to pray for you to be blessed and walk into all that God has for you. Amen. We're here every Monday praying for your finances, praying that you're blessed as you go through the work week. Today, I want to talk about the law of action, because action is what brings forth results. Now, the Bible is very clear. We see it in the book of Thessalonians. It's talking about working. We see throughout the Bible, if you do not work, you do not eat. It is the law of action, taking what God has given you, the gifts, the talent, the abilities, the favor of God, and going into the marketplace, taking God into the marketplace. Now, some of you are retired, some of you are on disability, you're not able to work, but we still know there's money that comes in and money that goes out. So we're praying for a financial favor over you today. But those who are working, those who are in the marketplace, you're bringing value in exchange for finance, then I want to talk to you about the law of action. Now, let me say it again, law of action, not law of attraction. There's a lot of people who teach law of attraction. If you believe it, you hold on to a belief long enough and it'll manifest. Now, the Bible is very clear. As a man believes in his heart, so is he. The Bible is also clear about going and working. So there's a law of action. Go forth. Go and do. That's what we even see when Jesus said, when you go into a city, proclaim, preach, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It was a prophetic declaration, but it was a speaking forth of the kingdom, and then go do. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers. We see there was a doing. Go way back to Adam and Eve, and we see they were to tend the garden. They had things they had to do. Law of action. So today I'm asking you, what is your law of action? Not just to go do what you normally do, but if you want to improve, if you want to go to the next level, what are you doing today that's going to take you to the next level? For some of you, it may be buying a book. I'm going to buy a book today. Listen, whatever your normal routine is, drop by the bookstore. Go to the personal, the self-development, personal development area, business area, and say, hey, I want to buy a book. And start looking. Just let the Lord lead you what book to pick up. Pick up a book on personal finance. Pick up a book on business. Pick up a book on relationships or people skills. Pick up a book. Study. For some of you, it may be buying a course or joining an online organization. Some of you is going back to school. Whatever it is, some of you is finding a mentor saying, hey, will you help me? Do what it takes to improve yourself. Okay, the law of action. Some of you is joining a business, starting a business, start an online business, start a local business, start a side job. Whatever you're doing that takes action, the law of action will produce results. Okay, they're real simple. Also, you must take your heart and surrender it back to the Lord. Say, Lord, I trust you with my finances. I trust you as we start this week. So let me pray for you, okay? Number one, make sure that you're going to take action. Can I get an amen? Post in comments. I'll wait. Post in comments below. Say, Pastor Wayne, this is what I'm going to do this week to improve my business. Pastor Wayne, this is what I'm going to do to improve my finances. One thing you're going to do, I want you to post it in comments below. Number two, all right, let's go into prayer, because we know that when we acknowledge God as our Lord and Savior and our provider, He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him, amen, who believe upon Him. So Father God, I pray over everyone watching this, that you would touch their work week, amen, that the Spirit of the living God, the Spirit of wisdom and the Spirit of favor would come upon them, whether they're a worker bee or the queen bee, they're managing people, they're being managed, wherever they're at in their finances, Father God, I'm asking you to touch them, to give them overflow, to give them supernatural abundance, amen, favor with fellow co-workers, favor with employees, employers, favor with vendors. Father God, for those who are out in the marketplace and they're selling and they're bringing products to people, Lord, bring the right people at the right time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Guys, I honor all of you. I'm here 7 days a week to pray for you, to believe with you. And listen, as busy as we are, we take time out to do these because I know it's going to touch somebody's heart. Somebody's going to be blessed with this. Amen. this to me is, I would love to come and minister at your church, your conference, your small group. Let me know. Go to invitewayne.com. Invitewayne.com. Short page will pop up. Explain how that works, how to get in touch with me. I'd love to come minister. Speak into your life. Prophesy over your organization. And just speak life into, from what God has placed within me to your, hallelujah, church, organization. I'd love to get to know you. So go to invitewayne.com. Make this a great week. Hit the share button. Somebody needs to know that there's a law of action they can take to improve their life, and that God is going to bring favor as they move through the world week. This is Wayne Sutton. God bless.